हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर सी आर चौगुले, हेड डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंग्लिश, गोपाल कृष्ण गोखले कॉलेज, कोल्हापुर. दिस लेक्चर इज फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ बीए फर्स्ट ऑप्शनल इंग्लिश. नेम ऑफ द पेपर इज मॉडर्न इंडियन राइटिंग इन इंग्लिश ट्रांसलेशन फॉर द सेमिस्टर फर्स्ट. इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव सीन द स्टोरी रेपती फॉर बाय फकीर मोहन सेनापति. Let us know the superstitions and social realism in this story, Repati. This story is a story of Mohanty family, but it is more a tale of the strong grip of superstitions on the society. The first hint of it comes when the mother of Shyambandhu Mohanty opposes the idea of educating a girl. Girls in those days were not allowed formal education. Education was not for girls. Their fields is limited to the four walls of their house. If she is able to cook well or look after her family and house, it was enough. This was the social structure. It was said that educating women is a sin, and if a person sends a girl to school, fate will punish that person. So that the old mother of Shyambandhu opposed Rebati's education. Her son doesn't give any value to her views because he is a modern thinker, a social reformer. Through him, the writer Senapati presents his view about social evil. A school started in Patpur, but girls were not admitted in that school. So he asked Basudev, the teacher, to come and teach Rebati at home. He agreed willingly. As luck would have it, cholera gripped the village and Shyambandhu was the first victim in the family. The old woman feels that this is the punishment to him by fate for going against social system. The second person in the family to succumb the cholera is Repti's mother. She is punished because she supported her husband. Now the old man abuses Repti freely with words. We sympathize not with the old woman but with Repti, who dies of a different disease, that is pneumonia. The tragedy appeals us because it is a part of the epidemic and has nothing to do with Repti's education. Fakir Mohan Senapati is a trained setting author of Oriya language. He is the author who was ahead of times and had foresight. He is one of those writers who dare to present the social realism to his readers. He presents, though he is writing, the evils in society and makes readers think. The story Repati is no exception. Repati is not the story of a girl or of the family in which she is born and brought up. It is a story dealing with the conservative society. In opposition of old mother, Shyambandhu decided to his daughter. According to the old woman, those who were supported the woman education, they are punished by providence. Education to women is against society, a sin. This story was a struck social realism rampant all over India. One of the reformers that were badly needed in India was education of women. Many social reformers have been working in that direction in 19th century. Senapati worked for the same cause through his writing. Well, what happens in the story has nothing to do with this decision. However, the old woman blames Repati and her education for the disaster that strike the family. But Shyambandhu shines out as a social reformer in his capacity and thus becomes the mouthpiece of the author. He echoes the thoughts and ideas of his creator and is not perturbed by what his mother says. इज लकी इन सेंस दैट श्याम बंधु गेट सपोर्ट फ्रॉम हिज वाइफ एंड डॉटर. दिस स्टोरी इज नॉट अ लव स्टोरी बट देर इज अ टच ऑफ रोमांस इन इट. इट इज नॉट द मॉडर्न रोमांस बिकॉज दिस स्टोरी हैपन्स अबाउट 200 years ago. The romance is just suggested through first as the teacher and then as the desired one. From that day, Repti seems to like that teacher. When she listens to the discussion about possibility of her marriage with Basudev, her behavior changes. She visibly embraced when Basudev taught her in the presence of Shyam Bandhu and was prone to giggle for no reason. Her supports to suppress it failed at times. Later, the way she goes to the door and looks at the street again and again. When Basudev went away to 5 days and was late to return even on sixth day, again indicates her attraction towards the teacher. Zamindars are known to be the heartless and selfish persons in literature and reality. When we begin to read about the Zamindar in Rebati, our first impression is good. He has allotted 3.5 acres of land to Shyam Bandhu. His salary is not bad. The Zamindar seems pleased with his work. There is no reference to his being angry with Mohanty, but after all, he is a zamindar and lives up to the reputation. When Shyam Bandhu succumbs to cholera and becomes useless, his real cruel nature now surfaces. He takes away the land from the family and forcibly takes away the 2 cows that yielded good milk. The author tells us that he had an eye on these cows for days. The salary stops automatically. The land goes, and so the source of income, the cow, also goes. Here, the zamindar shows his true nature, his heartlessness and cruelty. Thanks for listening me carefully and attentively. Thank you.